To do a tuck stitch on this machine is fairly easy. Now this is the pattern I used, or design I used, for the bubble stitch hat. You have, start out with 2 stitches, a tuck, 5 stitches, they're knitted, a tuck, 3, but then when you go back here, there's the other 2, which makes 5. So you get a combination of 5 stitches knitted, 1 stitch tucked. You knit 4 rows. Actually, you could even knit 5 rows of tucks and then 1 row of stockinette. This one here just happens to be 2 rows of stockinette. And then you go to the middle of the what was knitted, the 5 stitches, that 3rd stitch is now tucked. And just repeat that for as long as you need. I do have 4 repeats on this, but I added 2 stitches on each side because I do not want to tuck the end stitches. If you were to, say, make a hat out of this, I would have just 1 stitch on the end. That way there, it when you sew it up, it's going to match up. But this is just a little sample. So I know that I have the 2 stitches there. I start with the 3rd one, so 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. And then I could take my magic wand, which I know a lot of you do not have. If you do not do it, just go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, tuck. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, tuck. But, of course, if you have this tool, you could go ahead and move 4 needles out at one time. You're going to lay the yarn over the needles and knit the 4 rows. Then you're going to push these needles that were tucked, well, unless you do the 5 rows, I would do 1 more row there, but because I'm doing 2 rows in between, I am pushing these needles back into the work position. You want to line it up as best as possible. Lay the yarn over the hooks, knit the 2 or 1 or row, whatever you're doing. Now, before I had this on tension dial 5, and it didn't seem to go very well on that 1 row. Tension dial 7 is working up a little bit better. So if you have too tight of a stitch, and you're trying to knit those tuck stitches back into work, and it's really hard, or you jam the carriage, more than likely, the stitch is too tight. So undo it, or put your tension dial up. Try it at a higher tension dial to see what you get. And of course the 2 rows. So now I have 5, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, the middle one. Or I could even look, I could see where I did the tuck before on that previous time. And I could just go up or count along as you need. Lay the yarn across, knit the 4 rows. At least for this design. Push those needles back. Now I could even use my needle pusher to push them all back at once. But I don't mind, you know, every once in a while, even though I like to do things fast on the machine, I don't mind sitting here and taking my time. Lay the yarn across, knit the 2 rows. And continue. But I'm not sure if you could see how that design is coming up. But I need to do a few more rows here, take it off the machine, and let it pull itself in so you could see the knit side is actually the bubble stitch. Normally the tuck stitch is the purl side, but it's up to you. You don't have to do it that way. You could have the knit side as the public side. So here's the small sample I just worked up. Some of the bubbles are kind of sticking out a little bit. But I need to let this rest a little bit more, and the stitches will pull itself inwards. And yeah, of course, it's curling on the top and the bottom, but that's going to happen with knit fabric anyways, unless you do a garter stitch or rib to stop that curl. But I think you could see how I'm getting the little bubbles there.